Hello guys, welcome back. As you can see here, we're in the mood. Remember, this is a German Shepherd. He can kill you by laughing. He can make you laugh to death. Okay, now let's go back to where we were. Today I'm going to place the ropes for the small dead eyes. You can see here that we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Also another 4 here. One here, two, this is here, we have 5. Okay, I'll figure out why I have 5 and how, and also here 3 of them. So with this dead eyes, I will be able to make the mass come to me or bend it the other way if I have a problem and the masts are not centered. I mean, definitely for the second or third level of the masts. Second and third level. So let me put the camera on tripod and I'll get back to you to start. So guys, let me do some explaining and then I'm going to start placing the parts, the rope, sorry. We have 4 small ones here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Each one of them will be tied with a specific part of the mass. Counting from left to right, we have the first one over here. The second one will go over here, and the next two will go up here. So I'm not going to film the upper part, you can understand that. I'm only going to film this part here. So let me get the dead eyes and I'll get started. Now guys, I have tied the mast above and I'm going to calculate the height to tie this dead eye. As I have seen in the plans, the height is around this rail here. And also on the other dead eyes, I have a rubbing strake, not a rail, because the rail is very high, to tell me what the height should be. So, this is the dead eye I'm going to tie. I need to tie it around here, so let me cut the rope around there. Now, that's the hard part. Take the dead eye and calculate the height. You have to stretch the rope, but not too much, because remember, you're going to be able to bend the mast. So I believe here it's perfect. Some twist, some more glue, and twist again. I have the height that I need, right there. Now, where is the thread? Here's the thread. Sorry for that, guys. Like I'm saying every time, I'm showing you one way of doing things. Definitely, there are others. So, the way I'm showing you is what I believe is fit to my needs. If you think you can do it with another way, you're free to do that. Nobody will say that it's wrong, except for a bunch of idiots who know that they exist. So, first, some make a nut, pass it through, and let the nut to be the stopping point. I'm preferring a different way. Now, to calculate, we have to do that. Let's say that we cut over here. It's the first one, so it's hard to calculate. Many of you are asking me about this ingenious tool. This is a tool that is made for passing threads through a needle's eye. So you can buy it from the local store that sells threads, fabrics and stuff. That's where I bought it from. Let me see, this will go on the front, so from the back, okay. I needed a little more rope. I will do that on the next one. You will see why. Now, this rope must be tied around here. Let me see if it's enough, because I have... Yeah, it's not enough. I have to do it with another way, but first of all, let me secure this. I need more rope to do that work on the next one. For now, we'll do it this way. This is hard job. No, it doesn't go well. Sorry for that, guys. This isn't the best job I've ever done over here, but okay, it's acceptable. Now I have to do another three with the way I told you and I showed you already. Also I have to do the rest and the other side as well. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to place the first big dead eye. Just a quick remark, guys, this is the new dead eye that I'm going to place, and as you can see here, if I pull, then so the mast will be pulled. In that way you can adjust the center if it's not center when you did the placement. So you can adjust perfectly the center of the mast with that way, all the masts. Now, let me do them and I'll get back to you to do the dead eyes. Done, guys. Over 3 hours for just that. And of course the other side as well. It's turning beautiful by the moment. Also, I have placed couple of pulls here, here, and here, according to the plans. Now, we begin to make the big dead eyes. Let me place the camera on a tripod and I'll get back to you to make the first one. Now guys, let me explain what is the way I use, and like I said, there are many ways. You can do it with every way you wish. Here I have 9 dead eyes. Here I have 10. Here that I have 9 dead eyes, I start from the middle. So this is the fifth, this is the middle. I will place one line from here all the way here around this square mast. Inside here, this is going to be tricky, and then for the I will start from the middle, like I said. I will take fourth
and sixth with the same line, around again, and goes on 3 and 7, 2 and 8, 1 and 9, but start from the middle. Many of you may want to do it one by one. Okay, nothing wrong with that. I prefer doing it in pairs, except for the single one, and I'm going to do it in one. Some may say that you have to place first this side, then the other. Believe me, it doesn't make any difference. It's we're talking about some 5 millimeters, maybe less, of thickness here, because of the ropes, and every rope is going to be on the other, upon the other rope. So nobody would be able to tell the difference or see it, by the way, because here is going to be another low bladder and sails and stuff. So don't care how to do it, just do it the way you want. I do it my way, like everything else. So guys, like I said, we start from the middle here. Here, because we have 10, I will start from with pairs directly. So the pair is 5 and 6 first, 4 and 7, 3 and 8, and goes on. Again, around this part. And here, again, around this part. This is going to be easier, but it's going to be a little tough to pass all the ropes through here. So, let's try to do that. And remember, always from the middle, not from the edges. Because if you do it at the edges, I forgot to tell you about that. Let's say that this are the ropes of the rope ladders. If you start from the middle, you have a pattern like this. If you start from the edge, then on the top, one rope is going to be upon the other rope, and the pattern will go like this, and it's going to be ugly. So start from the middle. Let me place the camera tripod, and then we'll get started. So guys, I have the line, single line. Like I said, start from the middle. So we have to start here at the fifth. Be careful not to interfere with any of the other lines. Definitely, as you can see here, this in some point will go inside the rope ladder. Or maybe not. Maybe I can avoid it. No, yeah, probably I can avoid it. But try not to interfere with the other lines. So, we keep the same height. As you can see, this one wasn't my best job, but these are better. These are plastic. It's the only plastic thing that the ship has. Okay, is going to change that. You cannot tell the difference that it's wood or plastic if you don't touch it or glue it, but I can assure you that the gluing more difficult because the plastic has no pores. So there we have a problem. Make sure that this line is at the back of the dead eye. we need up to the height of the mast. The platform, I said mast, up to the height of the first platform. First one is done. With exactly the same way, I have to make all the others too, and they are a lot. And after I finish them, of course, I have to tie the knots to make the rope ladders. This is very boring and very much time consuming. So guys, I hope I have made enough videos to last until I finish the rope ladders and make another video. I finish this tying the dead eyes, because I'm going to make another video when I start to tie the rope ladders. So thank you very much for watching, guys. I know that you want to see it done. I am too, believe me. I will see you again in our next video. Bye bye.